It's also frustrating. You have to go see the eggplant wizard? I mean, come on. Nobody respects that game. Well, nobody respects as much as they should. You can buy items in rooms. It's pretty cool. Very proto-RPG-ish. I will be playing some platformers on occasion while streaming. It's a gauntlet of rape. Back up, dude. They're just waiting to put it in you. Don't allow them. Protect your bubble. Oh, yeah, you better back up. Back the fuck up. That's right, you punk-ass motherfucker. Oh, get dunked. I shouldn't even bother. I should just start activating my void. To fucking talk to retards in this game. Oh, he's up top behind me. Here he comes. Is he 20s? I don't think so, bro. You get out of my face. Yeah, that last song's pretty strong. But all the songs in this soundtrack were actually pretty. Particularly for the time, they're absolutely amazing. In a time context. This one's pretty cool too. That shit in the background, like, the dudes who made this fucking soundtrack were. I don't want to get into it right now, but I have, like, I'm not like a video game music connoisseur, but I am interested in early electronic music in its forms and stuff. These dudes were on some next level shit, particularly with this soundtrack. I think that's probably part of the reason why Metroid holds up so well is people don't even think about that. I mean, they do, but they don't think about, like, that's really one of the legitimate reasons why it's a good game. You know, people think, oh, well, I can put the TV on mute, it's still a good game. Yeah, but I don't know, dude, the first time you turned on Metroid when you were a kid and you heard that, you were probably like, oh, damn, this is some real shit. This guy's gonna take my leg out. Shit, somebody up top. I see. That riff right there is a rip-off of a Kid Icarus riff. Like a D. Derivative. Gotta get this quick. Here he comes. Fuck you. That's what's up. Oh man, I just had a sick comeback. Yeah. Coming out. Guns blazing. That was a 6-0 con- that was a... Yeah, 6-0 combo.